watching the president speak earlier last hour have now made their way to Capitol Hill. And I want to go to Rich Edson, who is live outside, where they are rallying still, some of them quite boisterous, and you can hear sirens in the background as well. So that crowd is huge. Rich.
Yeah, Harris, and they're still coming here, Harris. Tens of thousands, thousands upon thousands of Trump supporters are here. That's flashbangs you hear right there. We're gonna go into this as much as we can right now. They have gone up towards the Capitol, reached the initial part of some of the security barriers here. We also know that off to the right, so the House, what you're looking at right now, is on the right, the Senate is on the left. The House office buildings are to your right, and beyond that's the Cannon House office building. That has been evacuated. For those who are in that building, they've been taken out of the main part. And actually, you can see now, right there in front of the Capitol, the tear gas that is coming around. Capitol Hill officers are running all on the east face of the Capitol right here as these supporters keep moving closer and closer to the Capitol building. The Capitol complex is pretty large. You've got the office buildings for the Senate on the left, those for the House on the right, and the supporters are now moving closer and closer to all those as the proceedings are going on inside the Capitol. What you had earlier today was President Trump speaking. That was about a mile and a half east of where we are right now. After that speech, which ended just a short while ago, that's when these supporters started moving here to the Capitol, which was largely the plan to protest the proceedings that were going on. But now you've got people breaching areas where they're not supposed to be. Capitol Hill police officers are trying to counter that. We've had over the last half hour or so, the flashbangs you hear, you've seen the tear gas here, and the scene that you're seeing right now, Harris, people are moving from west to east towards the Capitol. White House west.
We seem to have lost our connection with Rich Edson, obviously with technological constraints. I mean, you've got a large crowd moving, Rich moving too. But we got the gist of it. Brett Baer, as we watched this, you know, we knew about the evacuations from the USCP, those two buildings on the Capitol Hill grounds. We knew that evacuations were going on, but now we're getting a better idea from Rich on the ground with why that's happening. And I think we have Rich back, so forgive me, Brett, we're going to try to go back to our reporter. Rich Edson, do I have you?
Hey, Harris, can you hear me? Yeah, Harris, I got you right now. If you look out to the left here, Sanford, if you can get Capitol Hill police are just running up the other side of the Capitol. That's the Senate side, the north side of the Capitol. That, by the way, is across the Capitol building from where we have the evacuation on the House side right here. So you have a Capitol Hill Police Department that is dispersed through...
Super good.
Difficult to get him, our reporter there, Rich Edson, as he moves, everybody moves around him, complete audio from him, but he gave us a good description of what's going on and what caused the evacuations there. Look, it's a massive crowd, we knew that, and they were happy when the president was speaking and all gathered there, and when they dispersed, that creates the challenge of trying to first figure out exactly where they were going and having to corral all of that.
Guys, if you want to order this, let me know. I will pay you the numbers, the cell phone numbers.
What they're trying to do, police, is keep this situation calm with a lot of people.
It's worth
together.
It. They got a lot inside.
I know moments ago you were talking about what was going on the ground. Now we have pictures of that.
So let me know if you want to order, and I will pay you the name and the cell phone numbers.
Is, some part of this crowd, while largely peaceful, a lot of it, there's some part of this crowd.
I can't wait for my rice, or I just go ahead and eat.
The U.S. Capitol Police have
my rice is still cooking.
Their security around there. We mentioned the evacuation of those two other buildings. We're told that the Cannon office building has now been given the all clear. So that suspicious package or that evacuation is going to come to an end. In the meantime, during
That's all of this.
We had the Justice Department putting out a statement saying that it has been hacked. Email accounts have been hacked by Russia. They say 3% of their email is down. All of this breaking this afternoon.
A lot to follow. Yes, and in the meantime, House and Senate floors, of course, they are dealing with the Electoral College objection to certification in the state of Arizona now. That's going to do it for us. I'm outnumbered overtime. Our special coverage of this. I'm Harris. Here's the daily briefing.
Welcome to the Daily Briefing. So you're watching an extraordinary day in Washington. Protests erupting outside Capitol Hill, while inside, House and Senate lawmakers are now debating as Republicans challenge Arizona's Electoral College count. Let's get a roundup of news here. Let's begin with Chief White House Correspondent John Roberts, live from the North Lawn of the White House. John?
And good afternoon to you, Dan. We saw something rather extraordinary today, and that was, as Martha McCallum really pointed out, after 4 years of unswerving fidelity to President Trump and his agenda, the Vice President Mike Pence coming out and contradicting the President after the President said that Pence does have the authority to unilaterally either extend or reject the slate of electors that are presented by Congress, or presented to Congress by the states, rather. In a lengthy statement that ran about 2 or 3 pages, the Vice President at one point saying, quote, "It is my considered judgment that my oath to support and defend the Constitution constrains me from unilateral authority to determine which electoral votes should be counted and which should not." That really flew in the face of what President Trump was asking the Vice President to do during that Save America rally, in which the President said this. Listen here.
Mike Pence, I hope you're going to stand up for the good of our Constitution and for the good of our country. And if you're not, I'm going to be very disappointed in you.
Well, I don't know if the President was joking or if he wasn't when he was in Dalton, Georgia the other night. He said it in sort of a joking fashion, but that didn't have the same joking tone that he had on Monday during that rally. The President really wants Mike Pence to intervene here and say, look, I'm rejecting several slates of electors from several states, and I'm going to kick the matter back to the state legislatures to be decided, which would ultimately bring things to the Supreme Court. This is certainly a scenario that the President's most ardent supporters, including Rudy Giuliani, have been pushing forward, but there's no indication at all that the Vice President may go down that road. For his part, the President saying and telling all those people, those thousands of people, at that massive rally earlier today, that he is never going to concede this election. Listen here.
All of us here today do not want to see our election victory stolen by emboldened radical left Democrats, which is what they're doing, and stolen by the fake news media. We will never give up. We will never concede. It doesn't happen. You don't concede when there's death to come. Our country has had enough. We will not take it anymore.
Dana, at that event on the Ellipse just south of the White House, the President had praise for his Republican colleagues like Ted Cruz, like Josh Hawley, like the more than 100 members of the House Republican Caucus who are coming out challenging the Electoral College votes. He has called the Republicans who say that they will not challenge those, the, quote, surrender caucus. Now, law does provide for these challenges to come forward. We saw it in 2000. We saw it in 2005. We saw it again in 2016. This is taking it further than we have seen in the past, but it's likely that this will not end up in anything more than these challenges being heard in the House and the Senate and then being brought back for Mike Pence to do the final vote count here, which for all intents and purposes looks like it will end up with Joe Biden being the 46th president of the United States. Dan?
John Roberts, thank you for the update. Let's get more now on the protests up on Capitol Hill. That's where Rich Edson is. Rich, we were listening to you just a few minutes ago. You had some pretty interesting updates for the 10th times on the Capitol.
Yeah, and it's still going on, Dan. Let me show you here what's happening here. You're looking now at the crowds that have approached the Capitol building, have gone right up to the steps of the Capitol building on the west front, have walked about a mile and a half from the Ellipse down by the White House where President Trump had been speaking just a short while ago, and you have had thousands upon thousands of supporters come here. There's lots of police activity on both sides. On the east or the south side of the Capitol, where the House office buildings are, there was an evacuation of the Cannon House office building. We are now hearing that the all clear has been given for staffers to go back into the House office building. So re-entry there has been authorized. And we have seen police officers running all throughout, reports of suspicious packages, plenty of people here who are looking to protest, but those who are also pushing and trying to enter. So that's a lot of the scene that we've seen here. We've heard flashbangs. We have seen tear gas fired by police officers. And that scene continues. And just to give a sense of the crowd here, you've got a massive crowd that goes all the way up to the Capitol building, to the right side there where the House office complex is, to the left office side where the Senate office complex is. People are still coming. They're walking up Pennsylvania Avenue. They're walking their way through here to the Capitol building. And so the crowd that you're seeing now is growing. This is a very evolving situation. A lot of anger here from the crowd with the proceedings that are ongoing right now. And we continue to monitor it here right in front of the Capitol building. Dana?
All right, Rich, we'll keep in touch with you this hour. Thank you so much. Let's bring in our panel. Next, we have Brett Baer, Martha McCallum, and Chris Wallace.